everybody. Welcome back. I'm Jeff.
I'm Jeff.
And welcome to the Gridiron. What we want to do right now, we want to review championship games, okay, from this past weekend, right? A couple real good games, all right? First, want to start off with the NFC Packers over the Bears, 21-14.
It's a great game. Let me do this one more. Here comes the guy again.
Whoa!
Sleepy dude. Packers came out.
Sleepy dude picked the Packers, too.
Good lead. Over there, 14-0.
Well, 14-0 and 21-7.
Yeah, and then 21-7, but then...
Raji doing the fucker.
Yeah.
The earthquake, whatever that dance was in the end zone. Yeah!
And then,
Woo! The freezer.
What's the backup's name?
Khalib Haney.
Haney.
Colorado State third stringer.
Yeah, throwing a touchdown pass to Bennett.
Yep. To bring him in 21-14.
Yeah, and then got the ball back again because Packers couldn't get a first down.
Yeah.
Start driving down the field, and I think we call it like this. Ended on a turnover. Did we say that? I don't remember, but possibly.
Well, I mean, it was all, you know, we said that, you know, it could be then the last team with the ball win or something like that.
Or last
whatever.
Team with the ball has to score.
Yep.
Don't turnovers. But
the only thing I had a problem with was when I was, it was the Bears had the ball. And I think they had just completed the pass or started down and it made it 4th and 4. It was like a minute 50 or 50 seconds ago or something like that. The clock was running. Bears still had a timeout left to go. And Haney, like, brings him up to the line of scrimmage and he's looking for the play and all of that and everything. And it's 4th and 4. And this is the season. There's no tomorrow. There's no next week. There's none of this, none of that. This is the season. 4th down 4. You got to get 4 yards. And then it was still plenty enough time. You could have dumped something over the middle or whatever, or, you know, ran the ball or something, got up the line of scrimmage and clocked it, okay, and it would have been 2nd down, and you would have been within, 25, 30 yards of the end zone. Still had enough time. Wouldn't have any timeouts left, but you still would have had enough time to, score a touchdown to tie the game up at 21. And they got up the line of scrimmage, and they just kind of rushed it, and they left the timeout on the board. I think it was really, really important. I think before that they completed a 4th down pass too, But it just seemed like it got rushed and he threw the ball over the middle. Sam Shields jumped in front of it, picked it off. Game was over.
Yeah, he should have just got down. He ran out running and fumbled.
Ugh! Just get down, pick it off, get down, win the game.
That's rookie mistake.
Ugh! But I gotta give Mr. Haney all the credit in the world because he scored 2 touchdowns, okay, and he was driving for a 3rd touchdown, and they certainly could have at least kicked the field goal there or whatever like that, and he did more than Cutler and Collins did combined.
Yeah.
You know, so a lot of credit to him. A lot of credit to the Packers, though. You were the better team that day. You certainly deserved to move on, okay. You made it to the big show.
Yep.
Now, we're going to the AFC, all right? Steelers, Jets, another close contest like it was a few weeks ago. Last time the Jets prevailed.
Yep.
Jets scored a safety, and the Jets prevailed. This time the Jets scored a safety, and they didn't prevail.
Steelers started out really good. Well, where were they?
24-0.
24-0. After that, no more scoring for them.
Nope.
Was it 19 unanswered points?
Yeah, well,
they got 10 points, the safety, and then they got another touchdown.
Well, yeah, they kicked a field goal, I think, just before halftime to make it 24-3.
Yeah, got a touchdown.
Yep.
Got the safety.
Safety, yeah.
Got another touchdown.
Yep.
And then all they had to do was stop Pittsburgh. Could have.
I think Steelers had got, at the end of the, I think they got 2 first downs there.
Yeah.
You know, it was very, very gutsy because there was, like, a little under 2 minutes to go in the game, okay, and it was 3rd down, I think 6 or something like that, whatever it was.
Mm.
The Jets didn't have any timeouts left, I don't think. But Tomlin called a pass play, okay. Now, if it was incomplete,
stop the clock. Save a timeout.
Jets get the ball back. And in the last quarter, the Jets just kept moving the ball up and down the field.
Yeah.
I mean, they moved the ball down to inside like the 1-yard line or so, and that's how they got the safety. The Steelers stopped them on 4th down while going to the next play. Roethlisberger fumbled the snap in the end zone, and Jets jumped on him for a safety. But the Jets scored 2 touchdowns in the second half, plus they were about within a half a yard of scoring a 3rd touchdown. And if they got the ball back again, they would have had like a minute and a half or so, whatever, left to go. And they could have possibly moved the ball down and scored another touchdown.
Yeah, because the second half was all the Jets. First half was all Pittsburgh.
All Pittsburgh.
So, they definitely could have, I mean, wouldn't have been easy, but could have definitely more likely to score, especially the way they were playing. Pittsburgh defense looked tired.
Yeah, they were getting worn out. Yeah. You could tell.
Because the Jets would hold the ball for a while. They'd run.
Oh, yeah.
So.
Oh, yeah, they had some nice long drives and everything like that, and they were, you know, they were proving themselves there at the end, but it was a little too little, too late. You go on the road, go down 24-0 in Pittsburgh, and decide to show up in the second half and try to win a football game. It's the next to impossible to do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but anyway, once again, with the Packers, the Steelers were the better team. Okay, they deserve to move on. They deserve to go to the Super Bowl, and I'll meet the Packers there in a couple weeks. I've got the Pro Bowl coming up this weekend, and after this weekend, we've got Super Bowl in Dallas.
And after that, looking forward to the draft.
Ooh, that's right. And,
once free agency starts.
That's right, draft and free
agency. We'll be there.
Yes, we'll be at the draft. Oh, yeah, draft. We'll be at Radio City Music Hall in New York City.
Hopefully at the right time this year.
Yeah, last time we went at the wrong time, and they gave the tickets out before we got there, and we got there a little too late, and we got shut out.
Yeah, because where we go, 3 years
ago? 2008. 2009, the Cowboys didn't have a first-round choice.
2008, they got Felix Jones.
Yeah.
We got there, what time? 12 o'clock? Midnight?
Yeah, midnight,
camped out. Yep. And they were giving out the tickets at like 8 o'clock in the morning.
Yep. That's what we thought.
You had to wait in line to get a wristband.
Yeah.
And then you had to wait in line again to get your actual ticket.
Yeah.
Which was like 5 hours later.
Yeah.
And then you had to wait in line to get in. Yeah. So we waited in line.
Waited
in line from about 12 o'clock in the morning until maybe...
I think they started like 10 o'clock or so. They started opening the door to give out the wristbands.
Yeah, and then came back like 3 hours later to get our actual tickets.
Yeah.
And then we actually got into the draft about, 5, 6 o'clock?
Yeah.
They started letting us in 6 o'clock,
somewhere around there, yeah.
So a lot of waiting.
Yes, yeah, but, well... This time we're going to do a little differently. We're going to get there a little earlier this time. We're going to make sure we're there and enough time to get the wristbands, okay? And then we'll have to, that's on Wednesday. We'll come back home. We'll go back Thursday, and we'll actually get in this time.
Yep.
Instead of getting shut out like we did last time. But, hey, we sat in a bar. We watched the draft on a TV, big screen TV. Had some wings. Had some stuff to drink. It was a great time. You know, very, very memorable. Would have been a little bit better if we were actually in the draft.
Yeah.
But we'll be there this year. All time we have for right now. Next time we come back, we're going to preview the big show, the big Super Bowl in Dallas between the Steelers and the Packers. But till then, I'm Jeff.
And I'm Jeff.
And we'll see you on the Gridiron.